Hello and welcome to Quickies, the show that's about as entertaining as a tramp fight, where both tramps are already dead. First up, this week in tech. Well, to sum it up in just two words, knackering. On Tuesday, we had that massive Huawei launch where they decided to launch four new smartphones. And as if that wasn't enough, a smartwatch and a fitness band as well. You can check out our full hands-on review with the Mate 20 and its superior sibling, the Mate 20 Pro, right now. And I've got the Mate 20 Pro here in my sweaty mitt, and frankly, I'm loving it. It's absolutely packed full of great tech, like of course that in-screen fingerprint sensor. And I've been trying out that camera tech, and frankly, it's bloody marvellous. Definitely stay tuned for a full in-depth review, camera test and everything with that. We're definitely interested in that Huawei Watch GT, as well as it promises 2 weeks of sort of standard everyday fitness tracking and up to a month of use with more limited operation. And that's just as good as the Withings Steel HR Sport, so it'll be very interesting to see if it actually matches those expectations. Go check out our full hands-on for all you need to know. This week, OnePlus also decided to roll out a tasty slice of Android Pie to the OnePlus 6 and previous OnePlus handsets. You get a nice slice of Pie-style gesture control and of course updates to existing features such as the Do Not Disturb as well. So if you're OnePlus 6 owner, definitely jump on board with that. And we also now know that the OnePlus 6T, the successor to the 6, will be launching on October the 30th over in New York. And of course there will be a London-based event here that we will be at. There's free booze, so why wouldn't we?
We love booze! We love booze!
Sorry. Getting hackies from the cat now. So stay tuned for our full, in-depth, hands-on coverage of the 6T launching on the 30th. And now it's the part of the show that's about as welcome as Piers Morgan. It's viewer comments! Whoop, and indeed, whoop. Okay, first up, pelado, it means peeled, but is a way to call bald people. Okay, so last week I read out a comment that said, Ti amo pelado, which Google literally translated to, I love you peeled. But so apparently it actually means, I love you baldy. Oh great, cheers. Glad you clarified that. Next comment is, please make a comparison of Brexit versus that Pixel 3 XL notch. Okay, that is genuinely brilliant. Well, in a nutshell, both Brexit and that Pixel 3 XL notch have caused a lot of undue awkwardness. They're both very much unwelcome, and they're both responsible for reduced subsidies for livestock farmers in rural Britain. In summary, thumbs down. Next up, Danny Stiff, great name, says, if you go to the Mate 20 launch, please could you hold them at knife point until they agree to release the Honor Note 10 in the UK? Explain you're a crazy Macum, they'll understand. Well, sadly, the bastards were searching bags as we went into the Huawei launch, so I had my switchblade confiscated along with my hip flask and my porno stash. So sorry, Danny, looks like it's exports only for now. Next comment, hoping you might review the new Samsung A7. Well, definitely hoping to catch up with the A series once all this other shenanigans is all over with, and if Samsung actually decides to send me phones again. And last up this week, shall I upgrade my Moto G5S Plus to an Honor 8X and why? Well, personally, I'd say that the G5S Plus is still a great handset. As long as you're still happy with the performance, the battery life and everything, then stick with it, why not? Of course, the Honor 8X is definitely an upgrade. It's got sexier design, it's got the much bigger display, and it's got that fantastic camera tech as well. Of course, it is a bit of a handful, so bear that in mind. But at £229, you really can't beat it. So thanks everyone for your comments. Sorry we couldn't get through many of them at all this week, bit rushed. But definitely please leave your comments down below and we'll get through as many of them as possible next week if I'm throwing myself in front of a bus by then. And last but not least, what's coming up next week? Well, for a change, there's actually no launches going on. Nada. Zip. Which is good because it means I finally get to complete my Pixel 3 review, which I've been working on for over a week now. It did actually turn up just after I shot last week's quickie, so that is good stuff. And of course, stay tuned for in-depth coverage of the Mate 20 Pro as well. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, you lovely people. And maybe I'll see you next week. Love you. Bye.